मॉर्निंग डियर स्टूडेंट्स, आई एम मिस नविदा शेख फ्रॉम बृहन मुंबई महानगर पालिका MCGM वर्चुअल क्लास. आई वेलकम ऑल माय डियर स्टूडेंट्स टू अनदर एन इंटरेस्टिंग सेशन. इन टुडे सेशन वी विल बी लर्निंग समथिंग न्यू एंड इंटरेस्टिंग फ्रॉम अ साइंस टेक्स्ट बुक. सो लेट्स गेट. Good morning, dear students. I am Mrs. Navida Sheikh from MCGM Virtual Class. I welcome all my dear students to another an interesting session. In today's class, we'll be learning a very interesting chapter from your Science 2 textbook. And we've already uploaded two parts of the videos of cell biology and biotechnology. This is the third part. So it is very interesting chapter, and this part of the chapter is quite interesting because we'll be getting to know more about various technologies that are used in order to make different types of food processing in fertilizers and various things. Okay, so it is a very interesting part. So let's get started and learn something new and interesting. Therapeutic cloning. Stem cells can be derived from the cell formed in laboratory by the union of somatic cell nucleus with the enucleated egg cell. ठीक है, egg cells होना जरूरी है उसकी मदद से, और somatic cells के मदद से एक new organism create हो सकता है in the laboratory. Various diseases can be treated with the help of these stem cells. Similar to stem cells, genes can also be cloned, and millions of copies of same genes can be produced. Those can be used for gene therapy and other purposes. Controlling the inheritance of hereditary diseases. Suppose अगर किसी के family में कोई particular type of disease है जो चलती आ रही है, like diabetes, तो उसमें भी control किया जा सकता है. ठीक है, continuation of generation, enhancing the specific tendency may become possible due to cloning technique. However, there is worldwide opposition to human cloning of various issues. Okay, so it is not preferable, but it could be done. Suppose if that person is suffering from Alzheimer's, abhi Alzheimer's disease or Parkinson's disease, these are this could be hereditary. So theek hai, isse theek karne ke liye ke taki hamare aage ki generations mein ye problem na aaye, to ye यूज किया जा सकता है, ये थेरेपेटिक क्लोनिंग यूज किया जा सकता है इन ऑर्डर टू ट्रीट दैट डिजीज, ताकि आगे जो जेनरेशन आएगी, जो आगे जो ऑफस्प्रिंग होगी, उसके अंदर ये बीमारी ना हो. इंडस्ट्रियल प्रोडक्ट्स और वाइट बायोटेक्नोलॉजी. वेरियस इंडस्ट्रियल केमिकल्स कैन बी प्रोड्यूस थ्रू लेस एक्सपेंसिव प्रोसेसेस. एग्जाम्पल इज अल्कोहल प्रोडक्शन फ्रॉम शुगर मोलासेस विद द हेल्प ऑफ ट्रांसजेनिक यीस्ट. White biotechnology, basically it is the application of biotechnology for processing and production of chemicals, materials and fuels. It uses enzymes and microorganisms to make products in sectors such as chemistry, pharmaceuticals, food and feed, paper and pulp, textiles and energy, materials and polymers. Okay, so this is what is biotechnology, where we make use of microorganisms and enzymes to make industrial chemicals. Next you have is environment and biotechnology. How biotechnology is helping in improving the environment. The very first and a simple example that you have is the cleaning process. Now you have various sewages coming from various industries and your household everywhere. तो इसे डायरेक्टली पानियों में लेट ओपन नहीं किया, डाला नहीं जाता. तो अब वहां क्या किया जाता है, उसके अंदर माइक्रोब्स इंजेक्ट किए जाते हैं. These microbes they break down the harmful things that are there in the sewage, and thus after that it is it goes under processes ताकि उसमें cleaning हो, और फिर उससे पानी को डाला जाता है into water bodies. Okay, so that way the microbes which are there, okay, the microbial techniques are already in use for treatment on sewage and solid waste. Sewage is rich in organic matter. मतलब सारी जो हमारे घरों से वेस्ट निकलता है उसमें सब ऑर्गेनिक मैटर्स होते हैं. इफ सच सूवेज इज रिलीज इन नेचुरल वाटर बॉडीज लाइक रिवर्स, द ऑर्गेनिक मैटर इन इट गेट्स ऑक्सीडाइज्ड विद द हेल्प ऑफ डिसॉल्व्ड ऑक्सीजन. ड्यू टू दिस लेवल ऑफ डिसॉल्व्ड ऑक्सीजन इन वाटर डिक्रीजेस एंड इट एडवर्सली इफेक्ट्स द एक्वेटिक लाइफ. ठीक है, जो प्लांट्स एनिमल्स पानी में है उसे अफेक्ट करता है, बिकॉज उसके वजह से लेवल ऑफ ऑक्सीजन कम हो जाता है उसका. ठीक है, as a remedy on this, sewage should be released into rivers only after oxidation with the help of microbial technique. I hope this is clear now. Microbes are useful on large scale while production of compost by treatment on soil on solid organic waste material. Here you can see that huge digs are there are huge pits which have been dug into the soil, and all the organic waste are put into, and these organic waste which are there, they decompose with the help of the microbes, and these microbes give out gas when they are oxidizing, when they are breaking down these solid waste. उसमें से गैस जो रिलीज होती है वो यूज होती है एज बायोगैस, एंड जो वेस्ट है वो यूज होता है एज बायो फर्टिलाइजर्स, बायो पेस्टिसाइड्स, दे कैन बी यूज्ड. ओके, देयर आर सम न्यू कॉन्सेप्ट्स इन बायोटेक्नोलॉजी मेथड्स. लेट अस अंडरस्टैंड अबाउट बायो रेमिडिएशन. बायो रेमिडिएशन मीन्स आइदर अब्सॉर्बिंग और डिस्ट्रक्शन ऑफ टॉक्सिक केमिकल एंड हार्मफुल पॉल्यूटेंट्स विद द हेल्प ऑफ प्लांट्स. We have all learned that carbon dioxide is absorbed by plants and they are capable of absorbing sound as well. Apart from that, there are harmful chemicals for us, okay, but plants can break down them. If plants are used for this purpose, it is called as phytoremediation. Some examples of bioremediation are as follows. The Pseudomonas bacteria are useful for cleaning the hydrocarbon and oil pollutants from soil and water. The fern Petrus vittata can absorb the arsenic from the soil. Genetically modified variety of Indian mustard can absorb selenium from soil. Sunflower can absorb uranium and arsenic. Now these are very dangerous elements that are there. So this is how the bacteria Deinococcus radiodurans is highly useful for radiation resistant organism. It has been genetically modified and used to absorb the radiations from radioactive debris. Grasses like alfalfa, clover and rye are used in phytoremediation. Food biotechnology, apart from agriculture, apart from commercial uses, it is also used in food industries. Food items like bread, cheese, wine, beer, yogurt are produced with the help of microorganisms. These food items are probably the oldest ones produced with the help of biotechnology. DNA fingerprinting. DNA sequences of each person is unique as that of the fingerprint. Due to this, identity of any person can be established with the help of its available DNA. अब DNA कोई भी part हमारी body के, like हमारे बाल से भी हमारा DNA पता चल सकता है. So this is called as DNA fingerprinting. It is mainly useful in forensic sciences. Identity of the criminal can be established with the help of any parts of his body found at the site of crime. Similarly, identity of father of any child can be established. This research is performed in Center of DNA Fingerprinting and Diagnostics in Hyderabad. So here, if there is a rapist, now most of the time here we hear, so many times we hear ke kisi ne kisi ka rape kiya hai. So that rapist, how that person is arrested. Now hum log jo CIDs dekhte hain, crime patrols dekhte hain, to wahan pe batate hain na ki jab police jati hai to wahan par they search the crime scene. कि वहां पर उन्हें किसी तरीके का ब्लड स्टेन या फिर बाल या फिर कोई भी चीज उसकी बॉडी का पार्ट, स्किन, ठीक है, डेड बॉडी के नाखून के अंदर अगर उसका स्किन प्रेजेंट है तो उस वजह से भी क्रिमिनल्स को पकड़ा जा सकता है. उसका डीएनए उससे मैच होगा और वो पकड़ा जाएगा. सेम वे अगर किसी को पता नहीं है, सपोज इफ देयर इज अ रेप दैट हैज हैपेंड, व्हाट हैपेंस इज दे टेक द सैंपल्स फ्रॉम द फीमेल वजाइना एंड दे send it for testing, and if there is the sperm present of the man and it has DNA of that particular person, to usse bhi pata chal jayega ki wo father kaun hai us child ka. Okay, so that way DNA fingerprinting is very useful in mostly it is useful for forensic sciences. Okay, so I hope this is also one of the very interesting thing that you should pursue in your future. As I told you that microbes are very essential for cleaning the environment as well. So here there is a special type of bacteria which eats the oil which is there in the water. So cleaning of oil spillage in oceans. If oil spillage occurs, it adversely affects the marine life. right? We know this. Now, cleaning the ocean without any harm to environment is cheaper way has in cheaper way has become possible with the help of oil digesting and fast multiplying bacteria. India born American citizen and scientist Dr. Anand Mohan Chakravarti has for the first time suggested the use of such microbes. Naturally, the credit for the discovery goes to him. Let us understand the important stages in agricultural development. The first one that we're talking about is Green Revolution. What exactly happened in Green Revolution? There were problems of population explosion. ज़्यादा population बढ़ने से ज़्यादा requirements of food होने लगी, right? Were started to appear at the beginning of 20th century. Almost all countries, especially underdeveloped and developing countries, had been badly affected by the effect of poor quality and quantity of food. Various methods applied for harvesting maximum yield for minimum land are collectively called as Green Revolution. ठीक है, सो कम से कम जगह में ज्यादा अनाज उगाना, अच्छी क्वालिटी का अनाज उगाना, ये सारी चीजें ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन में आती है. तो ये ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन एक्चुअली है क्या? इन ग्रीन रेवोल्यूशन देयर वाज इम्प्रोवाइज्ड ड्रॉप वैरायटी ऑफ वीट एंड राइस, पॉपुलर यूज ऑफ फर्टिलाइजर्स एंड पेस्टिसाइड्स एंड वाटर मैनेजमेंट हैज लेड टू द इंक्रीज्ड प्रोडक्शन ऑफ फूड ग्रेन्स एंड देयर बाय लार्ज पॉपुलेशन हैड बीन सेव्ड फ्रॉम हंगर. People used to die because of hunger, and in order to save that, कि जल्द से जल्द एक ऐसी quality of wheat और rice को उगाया जाए जो जल्दी produce हो सके, wheat और rice जल्दी मिल सके और कम जगह में ज्यादा yield कर सके और कम से कम use of fertilizer और pesticides लगे उसे. ठीक है, तो इस तरीके से क्या होगा, खर्चा भी कम होगा farmer का, ज्यादा फायदा भी होगा farmers को और हमारे लिए भी ज्यादा quantity of food available हो सकता है. Okay, so Dr. Norman Borlaug from USA and Dr. M.S. Swaminathan from India have valuable contribution in Green Revolution. So Green Revolution, the Green Revolution is a significant increase in agricultural productivity resulting from the introduction of high yield variety of grains, use of pesticides, good quality pesticides and grains were used in order to improve the quality of the items and improve management techniques. कि किस तरीके से plant को उगाया जाए, कौन से instruments use किए जाए ताकि हमारी yield अच्छी तरीके से और कम मेहनत लगे. The father of Green Revolution, Dr. M.S. Swaminathan from India led the Green Revolution as the project director and Dr. Norman Borlaug from Mexico supported the Green Revolution through the introduction of high yielding variety of wheat seeds. Let us learn about White Revolution. This White Revolution or Operation Flood relates to the rapid development in milk production that took place in India after mid-1960s. This name is a variation of the name Green Revolution, okay? Used earlier to describe rapid development in agricultural production in India. A name closely associated with White Revolution is that of Dr. Verghese Kurien. This is because the origins of White Revolution can be traced to the effort of Dr. Kurien at Kaira District Cooperative Milk Producer Union situated at Anand in Gujarat state. This organization is better known by the brand name of its product, that is Amul. The father of White Revolution, Dr. Verghese Kurien, is the man behind the success of Amul. He is called the father of the White Revolution. As we have Dr. Swaminathan for Green Revolution, we have Dr. Verghese Kurien for White Revolution. He is also known as the Milkman of India. Kurien set up the Anand model of cooperative dairy development, engineered the White Revolution in India and made India the largest milk producers in the world. Let us talk about Blue Revolution. Blue Revolution is the water equivalent of the Green Revolution and primarily refers to the management of water resources that can steer humanity to achieve drinking water and crop irrigation security. ठीक है, तो ये पानी के related है ताकि वो सही तरीके से इस्तेमाल हो सके. The name of the ongoing Blue Revolution is to rapidly increase fish production as well in small ponds and water bodies. हम लोग ने पहले पढ़ चुके हैं about how फिशेस कैन ग्रो. ठीक है, कैन बी प्रोड्यूस्ड, तो ये उसके बारे में है.
a boon to small farmers, the nation's nutrition, and its gross domestic products. It has resulted in increase of fish production to 5 million tons from only 6 lakh tons to fish 50 years ago. This includes 1.6 million tons of fish from freshwater aquaculture, although the yield from marine fishery has stagnated. Freshwater aquaculture is growing at a healthy 6% a year. Now, how this is helping? It is helping in providing with food security, providing nutrition security, it is providing employment. Fishing, aquaculture, and a host of allied activities are a source of livelihood for many people, to over 14 million people in India. A major foreign exchange earner, matlab exchange, matlab paise ke liye, people, they export fishes also. We have learned that. So you get money from that. Blue Revolution has encouraged fish farming, whether farmers rear fish in tanks, ponds, or enclosed areas under special conditions that promote growth instead of catching them from the sea. As a result of Blue Revolution, there has been a significant increase in the amount of fish available. Fertilizers. Now, fertilizers are of two types. They are used in agriculture. One of those is organic manure and the other is chemical fertilizers. I've told you earlier also. So water holding capacity of the soil improves with soil conservation due to use of manure. If you're using manure, good quality manure, what happens is the water retention is good for the soil. Okay? The upper layer of the soil essential in agriculture is formed due to humus formation. Various essentials like nitrogen, phosphorus, potassium can be available to crops due to earthworm and fungi. In soilless farming, that is in hydroponics, liquid chemical fertilizers are used. However, there are more harmful effects of liberal use of chemical fertilizers. It includes decrease in fertility of soil. So when you talk about fertilizers, fertilizers need to be natural and organic, okay, which is useful for the plants and it doesn't harm the plant. And instead of using chemical fertilizers, because chemical fertilizers will ultimately decrease the fertility of the soil over the years. Insecticides, although the natural immunity of the plant can prevent the infection, use of insecticide is not under control. Irrespective of the natural friends of farmers like frogs and insectivorous birds, pesticides are used on large scale for increase in yield. Pesticides are in fact a type of poison. This poison enters the food web through water and food and its biomagnification occurs. Various pesticides like DDT, maleathion, chloropyphos, etc. have been proved to be dangerous. Okay, so insecticides, as I'm talking that sometimes biotechnology is good and sometimes it is bad. So here we're talking about something which is not good for our health because along with the helping the plants. अभी कभार क्या होता है plants को insects खाते हैं although उनके अंदर अगर immunity है उनकी fight करने के against the insects but still there are times when farmers use insecticides ताकि वो crops खराब करने वाले insects को मार सके. But क्या होता है वो insects के insecticides हमारे पानी के अंदर enter हो जाता है और उस तरीके से हमारे food web में enter होता है और उसकी वजह से there are very harmful effects on our body as well and which is dangerous. Okay. Organic farming. Nowadays we hear a lot about organic farming. कि ये organic farming है, organic crops है. Organic crops actually होते क्या हैं? जो naturally बहुत पहले जो उगाए जाते थे crops है, जो plants है, जो उगाए जाते थे naturally chemical fertilizers नहीं add किए जाते थे, pesticides और insecticides spray करने की ज़रूरत नहीं पड़ती थी उनके ऊपर. उससे हम लोग organic farming कहते हैं. ठीक है, very simple. Nowadays, organic farming and organic products have become buzzwords. Organic products are being available and in demand for everywhere and it is increasing, ever increasing. Chemical fertilizers and pesticides have been used on large scales. These poisonous chemicals reach the human body through food and water and their adverse harmful effect on human and environment became apparent. मतलब दिखाई देने लगा, लोग बीमार हो रहे हैं because of the use of harmful poisonous chemicals as fertilizers and pesticides on the plant. So various problems like soil fertility and pests infestation have become serious. So as to overcome these problems, farmers are opting for organic farming. It includes complete ban of chemical fertilizers and pesticides and use of local study varieties and thereby maintaining natural balance. Definitely this is a very good idea. Okay, you can do it at home also. Organic farming can be done. हम लोग अगर normally हमारे जो pots है, tubs वगैरह जो खराब हो जाते हैं उसके अंदर अगर हम लोग plants grow करते हैं जो हमारे घर में उगते हैं और जो भी waste हमारे घर से मिलता है अगर उसको हम लोग decompose करके उसे as manure use करते हैं तो जो crops हम लोगों को मिलेंगे उसका जो taste होता है, जो flavor होगा, it is very different and the nutrition value is also more because इसके अंदर chemicals नहीं use होते हैं, ठीक है? Apiculture. Apiculture is about bees, honey. You must have seen the beehive, right? Worst method of harvesting or collecting the honey from these hives is driving away the bees by smoking the hive with bunching torch and then cutting the hive into pieces. This method causes destruction of hive and large scale death of bees. However, it is easy to collect honey without destroying the hive and bees. Its artificial bee boxes are So this is what is apiculture. Apiculture normally जो beehives बनाते हैं bees वो जगहों पर ऐसे buildings के ऊपर या फिर झाड़ पर ये मक्खी के छत्ते हम लोग बोलते हैं ना वो बनते हैं. But here basically what do they do is there are trays where these bees come and they make honey. They have these ready-made hives that are there. They come. They deposit the honey over there and later on this they have various techniques of removing the bees from there and then collecting the honey and then again this procedure could be done. This is what is cultivation of medicinal plant. India has been gifted with a great biodiversity. Indian citizens have established the humble and strong relation with the nature. We have a great tradition of Ayurveda that cures the disease with the help of natural sources. आज भी हमारे घर में एक सर्दी खांसी होती है तो हम लोगों को बोला जाता है कि हल्दी वाला दूध पियो, लौंग रख लो मुंह में, तुलसी खाओ, तुलसी का काढ़ा बना के पियो. Now all these things are what? These are all medicinal plants. ठीक है? So India is a country where Ayurveda has a great role. ठीक है? हम लोग पहले कभी भी कोई भी directly दवाइयाँ नहीं खाते. पहले हम लोग हमेशा ये घरेलू चीजें नुस्खे यूज करते हैं. So these are all medicinal plants that are very useful. And because of urbanization और ये जो forest वगैरह destroy हो गए हैं तो इसीलिए अब ये medicinal plants को अलग तरीके से grow भी किया जाता है. During earlier days, medicinal plants were collected from the forest. However, due to depletion in forest area, medicinal plants are becoming rare. Hence, medicinal plants are being cultivated. Fruit processing. We are daily using various products prepared from fruits. All are consuming the products like chocolates, juice, jams and jellies. All these products can be produced by processing on fruits. ठीक है, हम लोगों के घरों में jams, jelly, आम पापड़, all these things that you eat are coming from fruits. Fruits are perishable agro produce. मतलब ये खराब हो जाता है जल्दी और इसीलिए अगर उसे सही तरीके से प्रोसेस किया जाएगा और यूज किया जाएगा तो वो थ्रू आउट द ईयर हम लोग उसे यूज कर सकते हैं. ठीक है, सो दिस इज व्हाट इज फूड प्रोसेसिंग. फूड प्रोसेसिंग इंक्लूड्स वेरियस मेथड्स रेंजिंग फ्रॉम स्टोरेज एंड कोल्ड स्टोरेज टू ड्राइंग, सॉल्टिंग, एयर टाइट पैकेजिंग, प्रिपेयरिंग मुरब्बा, इवेपोरेटिंग एटसेट्रा. ओके, सो विद दिस आई होप दिस पार्ट इज क्लियर. इफ यू लाइक द सेशन प्लीज डू नॉट फॉरगेट टू सब्सक्राइब टू आवर चैनल सो दैट यू कैन शेयर एंड व्यू द वीडियोस दैट वी हैड टुडे फॉर यू. And please do not forget to hit the bell icon so that you remain updated with all the latest videos that we'll be making for our dear students. This session was quite useful to you. In the next coming period, we'll learn something new and interesting. Till then, thank you.